You okay with OJ Simpson getting out of prison?
Count one, conspiracy to commit a crime, guilty. Count two, conspiracy to commit kidnapping, guilty.
OJ Simpson could soon be a free man, but all that stands between him and freedom is a four-person parole board. They're going to hear arguments tomorrow. Simpson is serving a 33-year sentence for armed robbery and other charges. He's 9 years into that sentence. It's looking good for OJ. A retired prison guard who befriended the former football star says he's been a model prisoner.
He's been in that prison for 9 years without one write-up. He's helped other inmates with problems. I mean, he's gotten in no trouble in 9 years. That's very hard to do.
Okay, let's talk about it. Joining us now, Professor Jessica Steinberg. She's director of the Prisoner and Reentry Clinic at George Washington University here in D.C. and noted attorney Donald Temple. Let me ask you both, what are his chances when he goes before the parole board?
I think his chances are substantial. He's had prior favorable parole consideration. There's a six-person board. He needs four votes. He's been a model prisoner. If the politics that inform the judicial process don't inform the parole process, which I don't think they will at this stage after an excessive sentence of 9 years for the criminal offenses that underpin his sentence, I think that he'll be paroled.
What do you think?
So Nevada has a very high parole grant rate. They grant parole in about half of the cases that are heard by the parole board. That's certainly a point in OJ's favor. Many states hardly ever grant parole. Certainly he's had an outstanding disciplinary record, and that's another point in his favor. I think a lot may come down to how he speaks about the underlying crimes. So will he accept responsibility for his actions? Will he express remorse? Those are sort of soft factors in the parole board's consideration, but I think they'll weigh heavily.
Yeah, needless to say, this is one of those crimes that captivated the entire country. There have been at least a couple of movies that have been made since he's been incarcerated. So his name, his face, his image still out there. He's still a big deal. So what has life in prison been like for OJ? Well, guards have described the Lovelock Correctional Center in Reno as a cruise ship with barbed wire. They say the food is good, facilities are clean, and inmates call it easy time. OJ gets to play sports, he has access to a gym, even gets to watch movies and cable television. You called his sentence in this case excessive, is that what you said?
Absolutely. I think that the politics of the sentence, 9 years, given the circumstances surrounding the crime, given the pleas that were associated with the process, I think, and the fact that the items that he was retrieving were actually, at least from his point of view, stolen from him. I think that the crime is very excessive, even under Nevada standards.
Is it beyond the pale to think that there's no way this all went down without consideration for the crime that he was charged with but got off, the murder of his ex-wife and her friend, Ron Goldman?
I mean, you have to understand, we have to understand, and without any apology, that this crime had racial implications, black and white, and where people were on both sides of the line. And in Nevada, where 92% of the judiciary is white, and how they received it, it's at least from the black perspective, race certainly influenced the decision. And I think OJ, too, made some poor decisions. I mean, OJ could have pled and probably have avoided the harshest sentence that he received.
You know what a lot of people have said. Don't come with a race card in this situation when, in fact, it was your celebrity status and the fact that you had advantages that a lot of, you know, poor white and black people didn't have in the first trial that got you off. You were able to match the government's resources. You've heard as well as I have.
Well, I think that's a crock, quite frankly and quite honestly. I mean, the reality of race and the way that race informs, in addition to the fact of his celebrity, the race that informed here, from the point of view of a sentence, it suggests a double standard. OJ received 9 years. Similarly situated persons with less status, of course, but of a different race would not have received the 9 year to 33-year sentence for the crime with the circumstances that are attending to that particular offense.
Your thoughts on all this?
So certainly it was said and could well be true that it's impossible to put out of, judges are human and they are aware of circumstances that are outside the bounds of the four corners of a case. And so certainly it could be said that what was in the judge's mind at the time of sentencing were the prior allegations for which he was acquitted.
Yeah. One of the most noted attorneys I know here, one of the smartest. I got to come back because I just love this topic of conversation. Okay, if granted double standard in the second case in which he was convicted and given the sentence, was there not a double standard in that first case? Had he been a poor black guy or poor white guy with a public defender as his attorney, what are the chances he would have gotten?
Well, I mean,
had he not been OJ and rich and wealthy with all this legal expertise, what likely would have been the outcome?
Undoubtedly, he had the legal dream team.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And so, I mean, Johnny Cochran and the other lawyers were certainly a factor. If he did not have such a cadre of lawyers, OJ, like many African-American men and women and others, including Latinos, who can't afford legal expenses, would probably more than likely have lost that case.
Right. Let me ask you one more question. Now, if he gets parole, he gets out, you know, in a matter of months, he's still not clear legally, right? The Goldman's going to come after him. They've already won a civil case. You know, there's liability here, right?
Well, I think that his criminal case is completed. His civil case is completed with liability. There's no other relief, civil or criminal, that could be found against OJ.
I think it's important to remember, though, that even if he's paroled at tomorrow's hearing, he's not free and clear, so he's still serving out his criminal sentence up until that back end number of his sentence, the 33 years. So for all of that time, he'll continue to be under the active control of law enforcement. He'll have all sorts of restrictions on his freedom. He'll have to comply with pretty stringent conditions of parole. He'll just be living at home instead of in prison.
I agree in part. I don't think that it's going to be, I mean, he's a guy 70 years old. God knows what his lifeline is. I don't think anything, even to parole, will beat the prison and the continuation of
he'll be
of the sentence.
That's right. Okay, all right. But thank you both very much. And everybody's watching this story still. The parole board expected to make their decision tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock. You can watch it as it happens right here on WUSA 9.